Hi, welcome to CLLST. So in last session, we discussed what is defamation. So defamation is basically when you are hampering the reputation of a person, then you are committing the offense or wrong of defamation. So when you are making a false statement with an intention to harm the reputation of a person, it is defamation. There are certain defenses which is available. So for example, if you say something, but if you have made a true statement, so in that case, the other person can't come and, you know, file a suit of defamation against you. For example, if somebody has committed murder and you know that the person has committed murder. So if you are making a statement among others in the society that, you know, he has committed murder. So in that case, if it's a true statement, you can't be convicted for the same, or he can't file a suit of defamation for same. So generally there are three defenses which is available in case of defamation. First is truth. When you are speaking truth, it's a defense. The second is fair comment, or you can say fair criticism. So for example, if Supreme Court has passed the judgment, or for example, right now Supreme Court has started hearing about Article 370. So if Supreme Court has made certain statement or has passed certain judgment, basing on that, if you are, you know, making your opinion, or if you are criticizing, or if you are giving your opinion on that judgment, so it is a fair criticism, or it is a fair comment. So in that case, you can't be held liable for defamation. The third one is privileges. So when a person has certain privileges and he makes a statement availing that right, so in that case, the person can't be held liable for defamation. When we discuss about privileges, it's basically of two types, absolute and qualified. So what is an example of absolute privileges? We have heard about, you know, that there is a parliamentarian and all the members of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and State Assembly are having certain privileges. For example, Member of Parliament is having special privileges which is guaranteed under Article 105. So whatever statement they make inside the Parliament, whatever they are criticizing or saying to each other, they can't be held liable for that. So this is known as absolute privileges. This is done in order to, you know, give them right, in order to make them work in a proper environment without creating any hindrance. So whatever is said inside the Parliament, they can't be held liable for that. Although we know that what is the current scenario, they keep on going something, they keep on abusing each other, but since they are having privileges under Article 105, they can't be held liable. The second one is qualified privileges. So that is basically if you are having certain rights, that can be legal right, that can be moral duty, and basing on that, if you are speaking something, so you are protected under this category. For example, if an employer is saying something about his employee, or if a teacher is saying something to the parents about the children. So this comes under the category of qualified privileges. So basically three defenses are available. One is truth statement, the second is fair comment, and the third one is privileges. This is what is needed for defamation and what are the general defenses. We need not to go in much depth about the topic. Thank you for watching the videos. Keep watching.
Career launcher. Make your parents explode with joy.